I'm Tim Harvey.
I'm Justin Adair, and this is Sparkle Kitty.
Which apparently is growing out of the top of my head, which is, I don't know if there's a pill for that. Oh, okay, thank God, it's not actually attached. We are Team Zombie for Sci-Fi for Me's and Horror for Me's The Walking Dead Reviews.
Mm-hmm.
And we just watched tonight's episode of AMC's The Walking Dead.
And now we get to discuss the trope of the lesbian sacrifice.
Yeah. We would just like to say that we'd like to wish our friend Anne-Marie a happy birthday. This is her birthday when we're recording this. Mm-hmm. And she has long been a part of these reviews and hasn't been because she moved away. We miss her and wish her a very happy birthday. And now we will turn to the, I don't know if pleasant task is the word I want to go with for tonight's episode. Yeah, so I'll let you run with that.
So, it started off seeming very much like a filler episode, and it was. Let's be honest, it was a filler episode. It was Eugene and Abe go out to do a thing. Meanwhile, Denise, the lesbian doctor, gets Daryl and Rosita to go out and do another thing. So nothing happens inside the compound. It starts off like with this montage of like, oh, we're getting into a routine again. Oh, we're kind of happy. Things are going well. And then Denise gets this idea that she wants to go to this apothecary store in the next town over and see if maybe they might have some apothecarian left. And meanwhile, Eugene wants to take Abe to a smelter where he thinks he can start building more bullets. And that part, that's it. That's all that happens there. Eugene takes Abe to a smelter and they decide to see about more bullets. And Eugene tries to kill a zombie that has been smelted. It doesn't necessarily work. And so Abe has to save him, and Eugene's all like, why are you saving me? I can do this! Except maybe in a more, why are you saving me? I can do this voice. And then Abe's like, you have never been able to do this. And Eugene's all like, I can do this. And so Abe's like, fine, find your own way home. And he leaves. Meanwhile, Denise has taken Rosita, who's super angry because she's dumped. And ladies who get dumped are angry, you guys. I don't know if you've heard, but ladies, they just hate being dumped. And so they, and Daryl, who is having some issues with, you know, wondering if maybe he accidentally brought the saviors down on their heads because he let those people live. Because they found his bike last episode, remember? The saviors had his motorcycle, and Carol tries to... comfort him? I don't know if that's the right word. Carol's going through some stuff, you guys. And so Daryl and Rosita and Denise, the lesbian doctor, go to this apothecary, and they find the drugs that they need. They take them all. But Rosita and Daryl are super angry the whole time. And finally, Denise can't handle it anymore, how angry they are for, like, you know, no reason. And she, like, stops them, and she's like, she kills a zombie because she wanted to do that on this trip, apparently. And I'm skipping over the whole, like, she found the zombie thing that happens in the shop because who really needs that?
Nobody actually needs that, but I'm going to take us there anyway. So, at this point, when they have got to the apothecary, they are, they get the wonderful experience of looking at this strip mall kind of arrangement here. And the building that they are going to with the sign that says apothecary is covered in zombie handprints Walker handprints all over the outside of the building. So there was obviously some reason they wanted to get inside. Dustin and I are looking at each other like, yeah, this is not a good plan. And so they get inside and there's nothing there. And we're looking around and they find the barricaded area where they keep the drugs. And Daryl and Rosita go inside and they leave her outside. They leave our doctor outside with, I don't know, maybe a zombie? Who knows? It's hard to tell. But she's sitting there looking around and then she goes wandering because that's what you do, right? Is go wander when this is going on. And then she finds a room with a walker in it, and the walker is barely there, and scrawled on the wall in probably blood or something is the word hush. Hush, hush, hush. And then there's a sink, and in the sink there's a tiny foot sticking out of the stagnant water. It's really, really disturbing. So that's what Dustin didn't want to talk about, and I'm a terrible person, so I did. But we also have this bit where, as they're coming into this place, as they're coming to this town, there's a tree that blocks the road, and they have to kill a couple of, a zombie who was trapped underneath it. And they go separate directions. So there's the road, and there's the railroad tracks. So the railroad tracks are going to be quicker. And Daryl's like, no, we're not taking the railroad tracks. So he and the doctor go off down the road. Rosita takes the railroad tracks because splitting up, always a good plan. Or not.
And then, so she's standing there and she's like, she kills a zombie and she gets her soda that she's been trying to get for Tara all season. Daryl's off on a 2-week trip. And then she goes, you guys, you have so much going for you. You're so much stronger than me. And then pop, she's shot in the head with an arrow. And she dies. And so then Rosita and Daryl now have a stronger reason to fight the saviors than they had before. See, this is a new trope. It's called the lesbian sacrifice. And what it does, what happens is, they establish a character, a lesbian character in a show. They make people kind of like her, build some sort of rapport for her, and then they kill her off so that the main characters, usually white, usually male characters, now have a better reason to fight on. This happened in Supernatural. It's happened in Grey's Anatomy about 50 times. Those are all ladies. They just fight on ladies. It happens. It's like a big thing. If you want more information on the lesbian sacrifice, I suggest that you check out Heather Hogan's articles on Autostraddle. And I will give Tim her Twitter so that you can look her up. She is an awesome recapper who talks about this stuff all the time, because for some reason, when you write about recaps for shows for a lesbian website, you tend to cover shows with lesbians on them, so you tend to watch lesbians be killed off a lot on TV. Delphine from Orphan Black. It happens. It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. And it was ridiculous here. And the thing that was most ridiculous about it, I've already gone over my time limit, I hate myself for that, is that you saw it coming. It was, like Tim likes to say, and Sparkle Kitty is, like, gasping for breath because I'm squeezing. It was hand of the writer. The minute that Denise goes, I think I'd like to go out on a mission, you're like, that bitch is dead. And then they get to the apothecary shop, and it's like, and Daryl and Rosita are like, oh, no, don't worry about us. We're going to go in and get all the medicine. You just stand out here. And you're like, that bitch is dead. And when she goes for the zombie, she goes in the apothecary and does the whole zombie thing there by herself, you're like, she is gonna die. And then she's talking about her twin brother, and you're like, stop talking about yourself. You are going to die. And then she dies, and you're like,
we know we're watching a show called The Walking Dead, where death is going to happen all the time, where we're going to have characters that we like die. That's how the show works. We get it. But two things here. This, you know, the lesbian sacrifice thing, and this is something that just happened on the 100, I understand. I don't watch that show, but I've heard that there's a lot of controversy with a gay character getting killed off there, a lesbian character. And it's like an extension of fridging, right? For those of you who don't know, fridging is where the romantic and female romantic interest of the male hero gets killed off so that the hero can have a reason to fight, okay? Well, now, congratulations, we've moved it into the realm of sexual equality and gender equality, and now we're doing it to lesbians. Guys, if you are a writer, this is not a necessary thing. Yes, on this show, you can kill off characters. You kill off beloved characters all the time. But what you don't do is what we had tonight, which is basically everything about this character built up to be this sympathetic character who is a relatable human being who happens to be a lesbian. And then we spend the entire episode hearing, you know, learning everything about her. And it's just like, here's a mallet, here's your head, thwack, thwack, thwack. Now she's going to die. And you couldn't get around it. So not only do we have the lesbian sacrifice, but we also have what is possibly some of the most heavy-handed writing the show has pulled off in a long, long time. And this show has had its heavy-handed moments. But this is really, really just thuddingly obvious. I mean, the stuff that Dustin left out. You know, we sit there and you know, we got the splitting up. We've got her wandering off on her own. We've got the whole, I want to go out in the world and you guys are going to protect me. It's just like, I mean, this all this stuff is telegraphed. But then you have this, well, now we're going to decide to walk back on the tracks, okay? So, while we're doing that, she finds the car that she wants to get the cooler out of. And instead of Daryl and Rosita doing the sensible thing and helping her, they're like, no, forget it. I mean, there's all these little things that push. It's just so, you can watch the gears turn. And it's not in a inevitable doom kind of way. It's in a, we're setting her up to die. And you just get to watch us set her up to die, and we're not even going to be subtle about it. It's really frustrating on a multitude of levels, because ultimately, you strip it all away, it's bad writing. And you got good performances from our actors tonight. Although everybody in the show is just terrible to everybody else tonight, with the exception of our doctor, who is kind and nice and useful and helpful and dead. Ah.
This is where Tim's going to insert this whole part about how in the comics it was Abraham, and for some reasons...
No, he's not.
Okay, so in the comics it was Abraham who gets shot in the head after making a big speech. Why didn't they shoot Abraham in the face? Why'd they kill a lesbian again? Ugh. Anyway.
The answer to that question is that Abraham is in love. Abraham's got the big romantic relationship thing. Abraham's got the whole drama with Rosita, and oh god, now it's just terrible. No, he should have died. Sorry, Abe. You should have died. Sorry.
So we're getting closer and closer to the war against the Saviors. I guess we're supposed to feel something about that. At the end of the episode, Carol leaves. We're supposed to feel something about that. But I'm just kind of numb from just bad writing.
And what else happens in this episode is that they are captured by the Savior after our doctor gets an arrow through the eye, and they're caught by the Saviors. They're caught by one of the guys that Daryl left live back in the forest, who stole his bike, which they got back last week. And the guy's all like, well, I wasn't actually aiming at her. And it's like, well, that's great, thanks. And they've got Eugene, and Eugene's like, well, you should check out that woodpile over there, because he sees Abe over there. And of course, Abe's not there anymore, so it turns into a, you know, an ambush, and there's a shootout, and everybody, you know, a lot of people die, except for the horrible guy who killed our doctor, and he runs off, you know, to live to die another day. And then Carol leaves. Right. So here's a character we've had since the beginning of the show, and who we have become emotionally invested. and who has got some of the finest performances that we've seen in the run of the show. Melissa McBride is just an amazing actress. And she just leaves. We have a voiceover, and she's gone. All right, she's gone. So, it's like an afterthought, and it's really terrible. And it's just appalling how she just sort of just wanders on. I can't kill anybody anymore, I gotta go. Rick sent me away once, I gotta go. Well, Rick sent her away because she was killing people, okay? She has found this place in her where she realized she can't, she doesn't want to be a murderer. Okay, there's a difference in this show. It's hard to find sometimes, but there is a difference between killing someone and being a murderer. Might be a fine hair distinction kind of thing. But Glenn is not a murderer. Actually, two episodes ago, Glenn became a murderer. But yeah, it's just, it's this whole episode is just thud, mallet to the head, tactless, you know, it's bad. It's bad. This is a bad episode, I'm sorry. And it's very, very frustrating because we've seen them do much, much better. We had a great episode last week. Fantastic episode last week. And then we have this. All just to kill off a character who didn't really have to die.
Follow us on the Twits. Follow me. Follow Tim. Follow Anne Marie. It's her birthday. Follow her. Follow Heather Hogan. She's awesome. Check out Sci-Fi for Me's YouTube page. You're already there. Like us on Facebook. We have an Instagram, I believe. I think we are Tumblr. Anyway, all those things are popping up right here somewhere. Until next time, this is Dustin, and I think I may have caused irreparable harm to Sparkle Kitty.
Thanks for watching, folks. We'll see you next week.